Ladies and gentlemen, oh boy, do we have some things to get straight away into here in today's video. Last night, at the point that I'm recording this video, we had some insane updates to the WKBRL livestream, or should we call it the voice that hears you. Insane. So today I'm going to be catching you guys all up to speed with some of the more significant things that happened with the live stream, as well as go over some more update related content, such as when this next Brawl Talk could possibly be coming because of the live stream. So guys, it looks like we're heading into another Star Park related update here very, very soon, and I hope you guys are all excited. But with that being said, let's get straight away into it. Here we go! So of course, if you guys find this video helpful or useful in any way, be sure you're subscribed to the channel. This WKBRL Star Park theory crafting stuff is my bread and butter. I eat this stuff up and I'm gonna do my best to keep you guys on top of things when it comes to updates on the live stream as well as updates in the game itself. So make sure to stay tuned. But with all of that out of the way, the WKBRL live stream has changed and changed significantly. And before we get straight away into anything here in today's video, I wanna share with you all how it changed. Also, before we get into this blip, I want to give a huge shout out to the team that has been working on this live stream around the clock. Absolute freaking legends. I'm going to be leaving a link in the description down below to the Star Park Discord server if you guys want to follow any of this stuff closer after watching this video. But with that being said, let's get straight away into the start of WKBRL 2.0.
Transmitting live from Star Park. From the deep, dark depths of the gem mine to the snowy peaks of Mystic Mountain. From the frontier to Studio B. Forwards and backwards, across space and time. You are listening to acceptable radio on WKBRL.
The voice that hears you.
The stream was unnamed and basically blank, with no banner and no channel name, as well as no name for the video or stream itself. But now everything has changed. As you can see, the banner is WKBRL with some Russian lettering, the voice that hears you, which is the channel name and the name of the live stream now, which, can we just say, is creepy as heck, the voice that hears you. Along with the updates to the YouTube channel, we also have some changes to the picture of the live stream itself. We see some new things, some old things, and a different type of setting. As you guys can see on the far left, the radio as well as some of the other contraptions are the exact same, but just more vibrant and upbeat, basically refurbished in a way. Almost as if the camera was placed back and we can see the entire studio here, which it appears to be some sort of news station. But the newest thing that we can actually see is the poster in the background. We have always on WKBRL, the voice that hears you, with a very interesting logo which we have seen before. In a recent video breaking down some of the newest pictures over here on the starpark.biz website, we've seen the face pop up. As you guys can see on the beach like towel image, we see that face popping up once again. It's like a more happy version of the Star Park logo that we know and love, almost like it's laughing, which makes a ton of sense. If you guys have heard any of the sounds coming from the live stream, it has gone bonkers over there. Now we are going to be diving a bit deeper into this, but I do want to give you all a fair warning that we are still in very early stages. All the theories that are surrounding what has happened already are pretty dang surface level because all this just happened last night. And when I say all this, over 100 sounds were captured on the live stream thus far, vastly exceeding the previous version of the WKBRL live stream and the sounds captured there. So there's still a ton of work to be done, but I just want to catch you guys all up to speed so at least you know what's happening. So before we hop into any of the sounds, as well as why Kairos Time or Kairos Tim is involved with all this, I think it's very, very important to break down the banner as well as the new logo for the voice that hears you. So first, taking a look at the logo, as you can see, it's pretty dang bright and vibrant. We have that laughing Star Park logo there on the bottom right, but more importantly, smack dab in the middle, we have this Star Park logo that we keep seeing popping back up that has some significance to say the least. We've seen this logo pop up so many different times to the point where we just kind of take it as synonymous with Star Park. Park, or maybe the people behind kind of the wrongdoings at Star Park, the bad guys, right? We've seen it in several different artworks posted by the Brawl Stars dev team over on their social medias. This one, for example, we see the logo popping up over here. And in other various places, we've seen it when diving into some more Star Park related documents. So of course, this version is a little bit different, but I think it is the exact same thing. It just doesn't have the Wi-Fi bars in the background. So really, really interesting. But next, switching gears to the banner, where we believe some significant details are popping out that's giving us some information about when the next Brawl Talk should be, or maybe developments with Star Park in the live Brawl Stars game that we know. So taking a look at the banner, we have a big image of the Star Park logo, but this time not the grinning one, not the laughing one, but a winking Star Park logo. We also have the voice that hears you, as well as WKBRL and some Russian text there. But if we take a look at the very top right hand corner of the screen up here, we have scheduled broadcast 21A. So there's a fun little theory running around that this 21A means August 21st, maybe a Brawl Talk coming out on the 21st, or more updates to the Star Park development here. But I am in discussion with a group about Star Park, and they were a little bit reluctant about this one, almost saying, I don't think so. So take that with a grain of salt. I thought it was really, really interesting that it would be there. As well as we have a very interesting 3.0 there on the Star Park logo, or the winking Star Park logo, which we don't have any crazy theories running about that just yet. But with that stuff out of the way, we are next getting straight away into the sounds being captured on the live stream. We're not going to be going straight in depth to all of them or anything like that, because like I said before, there's well over 100 different significant sounds found on the live stream. We'd be here for years, man. But I will give you guys a general vibe to what the live stream is about, and make sure to check it out for yourselves, guys. That link will be in the description down below to the live stream so you guys can monitor what's going on over there. So here are the different sounds that we've captured on the live stream thus far. Like I said before, well over 100, capping at the point that I'm recording this video, 120 different sounds. So you can imagine it would take a very long time to go through all of these. But if you guys would like me to maybe in a future video try to dissect some of these things, or maybe go over the more significant ones that might have some interesting details for future developments for Star Park in a video, be sure to let me know. I would love to do that. But to sum up the whole vibe of this live stream now, is it's somewhat of a radio talk show where you have people coming on ever so often discussing certain things like the weather, or transitioning you into a new song saying like, hey, welcome back to this radio talk show. Let's get into the next song, stuff like that. But mixed with this upbeat radio talk show vibe, along with cheerful, fun music, you also have some very sinister moments. About an hour before I went to bed last night, we were around the 41st sound being captured on this new WKBRL live stream. But then in sound 42, the stream was no longer available, but it was just an image. The stream was still up and running. They programmed it to have that image pop up. But then, once the stream came back online, some crazy stuff happened. Replacing the music for about an hour, there was crazy, crazy non-stop laughter from many different people. Just to share with you all a little example, I recorded a blip last night that I was going to post to Twitter, but I thought it was a little bit too creepy, so I'm going to show it in this YouTube video. So, of course, this next blip is going to be a little bit more on the scarier side of things, but I'm guessing this next version of the WKBRL live stream is going to have its fair share of creepy moments, so I hope you guys are okay with that. It's all for the sake to understand what Star Park is and what we're heading into with this next update or updates to come.
Why are you not laughing? Are you not happy? Have you not been listening? There's no real reason to not be happy. If you are happy, act like it. This is truly a happy time here on WKBRL, the voice that hears you.
Things are pretty dang creepy over there at some points during the live stream. I think if you go to it right now, there's just a radio show happening, so there's music going on, and then ever so often someone will come back on, like you're listening to the radio show and then go back into music. But at points, at blips, it starts getting really maniacal and really, really creepy. When he said, "Is there a reason for you not to be laughing, or aren't you happy and stuff like that? Why don't you be happy?" I was like, "No, this is not a reason to be happy. I am freaking scared as heck." You're crazy. But like I said before, we will be getting into a little bit more interesting details about the voices being captured. We're still a little bit in the earlier stages of just kind of collecting everything, but then we'll be dissecting and trying to get some theories rolling about these things. So again, still in the earlier stages, and more on this later. Very interesting. But next, getting straight away into who is this guy called Kairos Tim. So sometime after the live stream change, this YouTube channel was found. It's called Kairos Tim, obviously a ripoff of our boy Kairos Time. It's not cool. So they deepfaked his face, and we will be getting straight away into this video because I feel like it is very, very important as to what has been happening here. But first, taking a look at some of the changes here. As you can see, it is Kairos's background, but the sponsors with Tribe Gaming have been changed to more Star Park and Brawl Stars related things. It's so dang weird. As you can see, the channel was created November 17th of 2020, so it was something else before they changed it to Kairos Tim, and this isn't some knockoff account or anything like that, someone in a third party. This is definitely like Star Park lore going on here. But as for the description, "I'm Kairos Tim, and it's Tim to Brawl. I am the real Kairos. There is a fake Kairos out there spreading lies and theories about Brawl Stars. He is not me. I am Kairos. Remember, Brawl Stars is a harmless game. Star hats are not mind-controlled devices, and Star Park is a fun place where nothing bad ever happens. If you're ready to brawl, the Tim is now." So the video title here is Kairos Tim's Brawl Theory, the truth behind Kairos Time, and Kairos Tim's whole objective here in this video is to kind of discredit Kairos Time, trying to make him out as the fake Kairos Time, and this guy is the real Kairos Time, trying to spew off that Star Park is to be trusted, mind-controlled devices aren't happening, and it's a place where you want to be, but not in a very, very good way. That's for dang sure. He's not doing his job correctly. So let's get into this video. We're gonna watch it through. I'm just gonna give my general impressions of it. Again, this is all pretty dang earlier stages, but we'll take it at face level. So here we go. I know it's creepy, man. The deepfake. I don't like it.
"Hello, fellow brawlers, and welcome to Kairos Tim. With me, Kairos, the show for brawl nerds like myself who don't get too caught up in the lore behind Brawl Stars. And today, we don't have any questions to answer. Nita and Leon's parents are just fine. Colt knows exactly who he is, was, and will be. And Star Park is a place intended to make dreams like owning a castle come true."
So throughout this video, you'll see Kairos Tim like go into a weird trance where he looks at the camera and is all like, kind of like dead in the eyes and just like not very responsive, almost like he's mind controlled, which gives off an impression, obviously, that Star Park can't be trusted, which I think is most definitely by design. But resuming here, let's have a listen as to what he has to say.
"With no sinister motives whatsoever."
Yeah, right. Yeah, see?
"Is an unalterable, indefinite, continued progression that apparently is irreversible through the past, the present, and into the future. But more important than the world."
So if you guys didn't know, we have some theories rolling around inside the Brawl Stars community that we might be getting some sort of time-related update when it comes to Star Park. Star Park is a version of Brawl Stars in the past. We had that Colette campaign some time ago that had very deep roots in time travel. And there's a ton of lore in Brawl Stars that has to deal with wormholes and different dimensions and time travel. So it's nothing new here. So could see maybe the next Star Park update having something to do with time, and hearing it pop up here is pretty interesting.
"He doesn't even have perfect hair like me."
Yeah, right.
"But more important than that, what is his problem with StarCorp's non-evil plan? Because it's obvious they're not up to anything other than facilitating fun, safe, non-mind control."
Right. Yeah, right.
"I mean, look at all these happy people.
And by the way, all this talk about star hats as some sort of mind control device is simply not true. I wear mine all the time, and it has never been an issue for me." "Not an issue. My mind is free and happy all of the time, all on its own. I'm Kairos. I've talked to well over 7 people that wear the hat regularly, and all of them say the same thing. No mind control. None.
So I think it's pretty safe to say that they are being mind controlled from the hats, given the mannerisms that Kairos Tim is presenting in this video. I just gotta say, your boy is happy that I never wore that hat. Your boy ain't getting mind controlled anytime soon, that's for dang sure. Star Park can't be trusted, man.
While we're at it, don't have to worry about becoming a brawler yourself. You don't have to worry about becoming a brawler yourself. You don't have to worry about becoming a brawler yourself. 8-bit is an absolutely run-of-the-mill arcade cabinet. Royalty, Beastlounge, Castle, it is not Gale.
I believe that too.
Nobody needs any help. Everybody is doing just fine. This is normal. Dragons aren't weapons. Thanks for stopping by. This is Kairos. Hit the like and subscribe button below.
There's a guy behind him.
Block and report, fake Kairos. This is the real Kairos.
So creepy.
Kairos. And remember, tune into WKBRL, the place for real Brawl fans who believe in truth and joy. But hey, that's just a theory, a Brawl theory.
R-E-A-L-K-A-I-R-O-S.
So creepy! So we did kind of start and stop during the video to dissect things when they popped up, but I think there is still a lot left in this video to unpack, which we will do so in time. The portion that really piqued my interest, where I didn't pause the video at all, was where Kairos Tim was saying, you don't have to worry about being turned into a brawler. He repeated it 3 different times, which was a very, very strong theory inside the Brawl Stars community that the people in the Invest in Your Future video were turned into brawlers, the brawlers that we play with here in Brawl Stars to this day. But yeah, if there is anything else super significant in this video that I think is going to pertain to this lore that is happening with the WKBRL live stream, I'll for sure make sure to mention it in a follow-up video to this when we go over some of the sounds, if we end up doing that. And I also do want to mention that there is a Twitter along with the YouTube channel for Kairos Tim, followed by a ton of people here. We have some pretty significant people following this channel, that's for dang sure. We have Arlight, Ryan, the previous community manager for Brawl Stars. But not only that, we have some other significant people following this Twitter page, which I think kind of validates this thing being real. We have OJ, we have Kairos, we have Tyrannical Turnup there. I believe Lex follows it. Yep, he's right here. We have Ark, the caster for Brawl Stars. So I think this thing is legit, right? So I would say if you guys want to keep on top of some of the comings and goings here in Star Park, or if you want to stay on top of everything, it's probably in your best interest to stay tuned to this Twitter page. So with the general baseline info out of the way of this craziness happening right now, I do want to get into a little bit of theory crafting. What's on the horizon here, seeing this crazy stuff happening? In one of the more recent videos of Brawl News here on my channel, we predicted that we very well could be seeing a Star Park related update based on previous examples. 1 year ago, the Summer of Monsters, which was the update that came out before Supercell went on their break, which we are in right now. But the very next update last year was the huge Star Park Invest in Your Future Brawl Talk, where we got a ton of crazy lore for Star Park and we got Colette introduced into the game, and then the WKBRL live stream kind of popped off, right? So I think we're looking at basically kind of the same exact thing happening 1 year later. The WKBRL live stream went on hiatus for a very long time, not shutting down, but staying live, but repeating the same exact thing over and over again. But now that we are kind of closing in on a Brawl Talk coming around and the update coming around as well, I think it makes a ton of sense to have this next update deeply rooted in Star Park. And a big one at that. The stuff that's happening now really kind of makes the other Star Park related stuff, like the WKBRL live stream, really small and insignificant. I'm saying it right now, your boy Ray is pretty much so 99% sure that this next update is gonna have everything to do with Star Park, and I am ready for it. It's gonna be really, really fun. So of course, make sure to stay tuned to the channel with updates with the live stream and other developments going on inside the community. Most of the time when it comes to the live stream and other things happening in the community, they are very strong predictors as to what's to come in the next update or updates to come. So your boy will be on top of all of that, that's for dang sure. So guys, that's where we're going to be wrapping up today's video. It's a bit of a longer one, but this is pretty dang important if you ask me. Make sure to stay tuned to the channel. I'll be notifying you guys next when other things happen or other significant things happen. I'll be sure to keep you guys in the loop on that note. But yeah, you guys, make sure if you did enjoy the video, make sure to slap a like on it. I'd appreciate that. Have an absolutely fantastic rest of your day. Keep having fun with Brawl Stars, and we'll see you in the next video. Adios, everybody.